So, you want to bag your Jazz GK. Welcome. You're in the right video. So right now, we're at Fitment. We're Fitment Engineering. We're Fitment TV. We actually do air suspensions. So, we have a Jazz GK here. All right? So this is the last generation of the Jazz GK. So we're going to walk you through sa mga thoughts namin kung paano i-air sus ang Jazz GK. Is it easy? Is it difficult? What are the things that I like about this car? Paano namin nagawa yung air sus nito? Ano nakalagay dito? Lahat ng yun matututunan nyo sa video ito. So we're focusing on a build summary after we've done the car. Let's talk about the car. I think it's easier to show the air suspension after we've done the car. So that's something that we want to do on this video. So come along. Let's learn. Let's educate ourselves kung paano i-air sus ang Jazz GK. Intro. So the Jazz GK, we're here. And as you can see, naka-jack stand yung kotse. We're actually done with the build, pero we're doing our final checking and I was like, it's a perfect time to show you guys ano yung finished product and we can actually easily discuss each side of the car, my thoughts, how easy it is, how difficult it is to bag this car. So, konting history lang. Ito na ang last ng Jazz. This is the last Honda Jazz na sa generation na ito. So, you won't be able to see another one of these because pinalta na siya ng hot hatch na bago ng Honda, which is the Honda City Hatchback. So, sad. It's sad. It's very sad for the car industry. But, this is actually a great platform. So now we're going to discuss with you the technical details on how to bag this car. The sizes of wheels na pinili ng may-ari. We're going to discuss that all. So yeah, we're going to show you the front, the rear, the setup sa likod. We're going to show you the wheels. So ano magandang specs na meron tayo for your wheels. And we're going to show you everything. And discuss natin. Baka kasi magustuhan nyo rin mag-slam ng inyong Jazz GK. So this is the perfect video for you. Keep watching. So we're at the front of the vehicle. So on Jazz GK is very similar to Honda City suspension type. We have a D1 spec coilover right here. So it's actually motorsport coilover, so it's a bit stiffer than usual. Yes, we are sporting a coilover conversion. We have an airbag here. I can show you a deeper angle later. But for now, the things that you need to worry about is because this is a McPherson strut. Basically, ang ibig ko sabihin doon in layman's term is that the whole shock actually moves, all right? When I move the vehicle's, when I turn the vehicle's steering wheel, let me show you, the whole coilover moves. So that's something that you need to worry about pag mga ganyang type of strut or type of suspension. So we're gonna start the car real quick. As you can see, I'll turn the steering wheel. And as you can see, the whole strut and the whole, everything is moving along the steering wheel. Kung saan ka pumunta, dun siya pupunta. This is what we call a McPherson strut. So, hindi siya katulad ng mga sa Lexus ko na hindi umiibo yung shocks. So, mga independent suspensions yung mga yon. So, yun lang yung kailangan tandaan dito. So, if it is turning, ito mga kailangan mong isipin dyan eh. If it is turning, will your hose, okay, ng air sus mo ba ay secured? You need to worry na itong hose line natin is tumama dito pag lumiliko siya the other way. Yung bag mo ba, okay, since gumagalaw yung buong bags mo, ito lang challenge sa mga ganitong economy cars. Gumagalaw yung buong shocks. So pag meron kang mga foreign objects sa loob, you need to worry about it na hindi siya, you know, tamaan. So left and right position. Good, clear. This is also part of our final checking for the car. If may mapapansin kami dito before release, we can just always go back to the video. So now, what you see in your face is the airbags. Do you want to see it in action? Kung paano siya na-depressurize and pressurize. So ngayon siya ay depressurized. Now we're going to pressurize it. So as you can see, ganyan mag-pressurize yung airbags. Something you don't see and something na hindi namin pakita sa inyo na pwede namin pakita sa inyo ngayon. Alright, one more. So that is the nature of the bags. As you can see, it's really beautiful pag nasa in-action na talaga siya. So ngayon, it's depressurized, actually soft. You can squeeze it. Alright? Yan lang. What can I say about the Jazz GK's wheel well at saka strut tower? It's actually pretty spacious. So, here's another close-up view pag siya ay gumagalaw sa taas. As you can see, we need to really keep an eye out sa mga kailangan naming iwasan. So ito ay part ng final checking talaga. So yeah. All right, we're at the back side of the car and we have a better view of the airbag. It is a divorce spring. We still have the D1 spec coil over here na shocks. And we have the airbag here divorced from the shocks. This is very common for economy cars na may single beam or yung single torsion bar sa likod. So, they are dependent suspension, hindi siya independent. Something that you have to note with your builder is that itong part ng ito ng GK is actually really tight. So you really have to offset the bags and dapat may lock sa taas yan so it doesn't fall off. It's a design na pinagtatalunan ng mga builder, but preferably ako, gusto ko may lock ang airbag sa taas, gusto ko may lock ang airbag sa ilalim. So, let's show you the airbag in action. So, yan, I fully inflated at around 120 PSI, 130. So, let's deflate it. So, audio warning is gonna be loud. So, hindi mo siya masyadong makikita makompress kasi nakababa nga yung naka-jack stand siya. So, to know that's depressurized, edi pisilin natin. Ayan. So yeah, that is the rear side of the Jazz. Something na kailangan nyo lang malaman is that your builder has to be wary enough of the mga kailangang iwasan. And we at Fitment, we can do that for you. That's why we're making this video. Para makita nyo yung airbag, let's zoom out a bit just to show you mga clearances na kailangan mong isipin. Let's zoom in. Alright, up, down, that's it. Pretty clear, the hose line went underneath. So that's the only way, the safe way to do it in our books. So yeah, that is the rear side of the Jazz. So right now, we're at the back of the car. This is the system. So pakita lang namin sa inyo yung layout nito. And I need to discuss something with you later as well. So as you can see, this is our fitment management system. This is the new system na meron tayo. It's actually the new case and everything with the industrial socket, similar to Acure, Airlift. So we're trying to step up our game. At least move natin yung product natin internationally or nationally muna. Pero that is the dream, di ba? That is the dream. So ngayon, it's sporting a pressure sensor package. And you may have noticed something. Oh, bakit ganun, boss? Magkaiba yung pump niya. Magkaiba yung pump niya dun sa kanan. This is the pump. Magkaiba yung pump niya sa kanan dun sa kaliwa. Bakit ganun? Ano nangyari? So yun, kung napansin niyo yung pump kanina, yes, it actually came from another shop. Ito yung mga gamit na ginamit nila dati. So, hindi pa tumagal yung unit sa kanila sa gumawa dati ng ilang araw. Nag-decide na yung client na palitan na lahat ng bago. So ito yung ginamit nila, stock shocks. And yeah, yung management system. Anyway, I'm not gonna get into that. That's for another, that's drama as well. So, bakit niya pinaltan? Pinaltan niya kasi itong mga bags na ito is actually too stiff for the car. It's too thick. Hindi niya ma-air down yung airbag na maayos ng kotse. So, it's giving him complications. So, he just opted for our system, brand new. Kinalas na lang ulit. Nag-usap na naman sila ng business owner. I think they're gonna refund it. I don't know. Labas na ako dun, right? So, simple setup lang tayo sa likod. Sacrifice muna na spare tire para mas malinis, mas tahimik. Hatchback to, remember? So, you really have to choose. Kung gusto mo nasa labas, keep your spare tire. It's gonna be noisy, pero if it's going to be nasa ilalim, significantly mas mahina siya. Diba? Yeah. And yan yung management system natin. Hope you like this na in-depth detail na pinapakita namin sa inyo. I-appreciate naman natin ang wiring ng boys. Sobrang linis. Alright? Yan yung system, yan yung pump ng kabilang shop. So we really use the other pump kasi kawawa naman yung client. He already spent 85,000 dun sa dating air suspension. Tapos gagastos pa siya ng brand new sa amin. So we just helped him out. It's not always about the money, boys. It's all about the craftsmanship, alright? So ayan, wrap things up tayo dito sa likod.
So welcome to the perspective view ng Jazz. I wanted to do a test drive video, pero I figured that a voiceover like this will be better for you to see yung up and down damping ng kotse. As you can see, nilalaro-laro ko dyan yung pressure para makita niyo yung movement ng kotse. Now, we are driving. Makita niyo, malubak yung daan. Tingnan niyo mabuti yung galaw ng gulong, yung damping ng gulong sa pavement, tsaka sa lubak. That's something very significant na kailangan mo makita. So, very interesting, di ba? I hope you like this. We really want to show you most of the stuff para hindi kayo mahirapan mag, ano, visualize. So ito yung normal condition, normal road sa likod to, ah. Rear view. So you can see, maganda yung D1 spec coilover. It's holding the wheels, yung damping maganda. And then ngayon, sa harap naman tayo. Maganda to, I really like this shot kasi I can see the wheels turning. So makikita mo kung paano yung normal operations ng McPherson strut or ng steering wheel mo pag nagda-drive ka. So as you can see, mag-U-turn tayo dito ngayon. Thank you sa mga sundalo na nag-assist sa akin dito. Yan. I really like the dynamics ng kotse, lalo dito yan. Kita mo yung kung paano ako mag, makikita mo yung minor movement na steering wheel mo. And as you can see, the damping of the wheel is really good. Kita mo, air suspension, hindi siya masyadong bouncy. Diba? Kita nyo. Actually, it is not bouncy at all. The damping is really good. Diba? Ang tining ng takbo ng kotse, that's coilovers on air suspension. Eh, may sumingit sa akin tricycle. Motorsiklo. So yeah, pabalik ng shop. Giving it around 40 kilometers per hour na speed dito. Ayan, kita mo yung maliliit na kano. Ayan, no, iniiwasan ko. Kita mo yung maliliit na movement ng wheel. It's amazing to see. So, balik tayo sa lubak. Okay? As you know, sa shop namin, hindi kami nakasemento papunta sa loob. So, there's a bit of gravel. See the damping? Oh, di ba? Alright. Ayos. Perfect. I really love showing this to people kasi this is what I crave for. The dynamics ng kotse sa air suspension is really fun. So it's very interesting. So i-air out muna natin to. Siyempre, ayabangan namin kayo na konti. Ayos. Amazing. Alright.
So ngayon, dito tayo sa Jazz ulit. And tapos na siya. We're going to connect to the device ngayon. So, meron na bang value? Yeah, meron na. So, ngayon, i-air out natin real time. Tingnan natin yung drop niya ngayon. So, we were discussing how good the suspension was, how easy it is to work. Ngayon, tingnan natin yung drop niya ngayon sa in real life. So, it's gonna get loud. So, bababa yung kotse, bababa rin tayo. Okay? Dahan-dahan lang. Well, actually, na-drop na namin to. So, obviously, we know the drop already. So, ngayon, as you can see, the front is actually fender to lip. The rear is actually almost fender to lip. Pero, sadly, nagrarab pa yung goma niya. So, a bit of pull pa siguro. Pero sa camera, siguro ninyo na makita. Probably, it's actually fender to lip na sa mata nyo. So, what are your thoughts sa drop ng kotse? Drop ng kotse is actually really good. It's actually easy to slam these cars. If you have a Jazz GK and you want to do air suspension, it's very easy. It's very easy. So you might ask the question, the golden question is, ano yung magandang set ng mags para dito? Okay, 17 by 8.5, offset 32. Goods na yan. Yan yun mismo. Probably you can sport 5mm spacer sa unahan. That's going to be a offset 27 sa unahan. If you want it to poke out a bit sa unahan, ang camber natin ay 3 sa unahan, negative 2 sa likod. Or maybe negative 1.5 sa likod. So, negative 3, negative 1.5, negative 2 is actually really good. So, yun yung mga kailangan nyo tandaan if you want to bag your Jazz GK last generation. Yeah, sad. So, yun. Another thing to note is that you really have to talk to your builder. Kung kami ang gagawa, you're already watching this video, wala na kayong problema. If you're not gonna have us as your builder, pakita nyo lang tong video na to. Be careful sa unahan, sa mga sasabitan. Be careful sa likod kasi divorced. I-offset niyo yung bag. That's it. So nakita niyo rin yung layout sa likod. How was it? Was it nice? I would rate this car right now as a solid, solid build. I would rate it as a 8 out of 10. The car was a little rough nung hawakan namin, pero all in all, yeah. I was really happy with this car. Very light, very easy to work on, very light and nimble car. I really like it. It's easy to get around. Sarap yung air suspension. Let's do another air up. Alright, stability check na rin tayo bago release ng kotse. This car is actually going home tomorrow. So, binivideohan ko na lahat ng kailangan i-test. This video is actually our last final check. Air out. As you can see, medyo may crunching noise sa likod. Pero, yeah. Goma na yun. Yan ang 3, preset 3, preset 2, and preset 1. And lastly, let's air out the car. So you want to bag your Jazz DK. This is how. Hope you like that. Hope you actually learned something. Hope you like that na pinakita namin yung mga details na hindi namin mapakita sa build vlog. And let me know down below sa comment section if this is actually a good format for you. As a consumer, as a future client, does this help you, enlighten you, do air suspension? Pinapakita namin yung mga hindi namin napapakita. And yeah, hope you like that. It's been Kyle from Fitment Engineering and this has been Fitment TV. Hope you like this episode. Comment down below sa mga gusto nyong i-improve. Camera angles, sound quality. Let me know. Tingnan natin. I can actually improve on it. Give me your feedback. Let's adjust on it. So hope you like this. This will be the format for all the build vlogs to follow. CRV naman ang sunod. Okay? Shout out ulit sa Carporn Racing. June 1, may closing sale sila. Check it out. Baka meron kayo mabibili sa kanila. Alright? Support them. And adios. That's it. Bye.